Welcome, everybody. My name's Hunter, and I'm happy to be here today to officiate this wedding. I was going to do the hour and 45 minute version, but it's a little bit cold, so we'll speed up a little bit. Do you? As Sandy and Peter wanted this moment to be special, they're grateful to you, their friends and family, for being here with them today. You've been an important part of their lives so far, and they look forward to your continued love and support as they journey through life together as a married couple. Peter and Sandy would also like to recognize all those who are not with us today, as they are certainly missed but not forgotten on this wonderful day of celebration. So as we start, I'd ask you to quiet your hearts, your minds, and your cell phones, please, as we open with a word of prayer. Beloved God, we welcome your presence in our hearts today. We have come together as a small community to witness and bless the vows of Sandy and Peter at the beginning of their journey together as a married couple. We ask that you bless them with a loving, healthy, and happy marriage. Amen.
Amen. Peter James Whitaker. It took me a while to accept that what we have is true, because it felt too easy. The way they say we must find someone to complete us, but that isn't true. I was at a point in my life where I accepted things as they were, and I was happy and content. But God said, Sandy, this journey isn't over yet, and our paths crossed again. One thing led to the next, and 7+ years later, I'm here and happy to say I do. I do promise to support and take care of you. I do promise to be loyal, committed, and respect you. I do promise to push you, and you can be sure I promise to cuss you when you need it. I know you are warned that I am a tad crazy, but I'm proud and happy to say you have brought a level of peace to my life that crazy Sandy has been laid to rest. Now, if you push Sandra enough, I can't promise you I can't, might not be crazy, but I believe God has given us the tools to work through any obstacle that comes your way. Peter, not only did you love me and accept me for who I am, but you accepted and loved CJ. As of your own, and I thank you. Thank you for also blessing me with another November born, my IJW. I do promise to continue to love him and raise him as my own. Peter James, we will have good days and bad, but I'm not afraid. The bond we have is undeniable. My best friend, my confidant, my support. We move in sync with little things that sometimes it's a little weird, but we make a great team. Happy just doesn't explain the way I feel, and the love I have for you really can only be described as no other than spiritual. You make my soul happy. I do promise to love you, Peter James Whitaker, always and forever. I really do.
It's pretty unique. What you may not have known is when we reconnected, that was a pretty low point in my life. I didn't know then, but I often look back and ask myself, bro, where the hell were you going in life? And where would you be right now if you didn't let Sandy seduce you on that boat cruise? She was so determined. All jokes aside, you took me into your home, and I mean that literally, as in came over one night and never went back to my own home. And you took me into your life, and we haven't looked back. Sure, we have had our ups and downs, and at times we didn't know if we would make it. But I believe God brought us together for a reason, and I thank him every day for bringing you into my life. You have accepted all of me and have made me a better person. You have accepted my son and my family, and you love them like your own. You never tried to change me, you only tried to make me a better person, and I thank you for that. Not only am I marrying the woman that I love, I'm also marrying my best friend. I love you now and forever.